Thank you. morning, everybody. Good morning to those of you at home as well. We're happy to see you guys today. Today is going to be a little bit different of a service. If you're watching online, you probably already saw the title of today. It says, All Music. What does that mean? It means we're going to do a lot of music today. You guys are in for an extra special treat. You don't have to hear me preach today, right? Yes. Always good to hear a lot of woos on that. Yeah, so, but you still got to stick with me through some announcements first. The first is, if this is your first time with us, or maybe it's been a while, or maybe your information has changed, or maybe you have a prayer request or something you'd like us to know, you can give us all of that information by filling out the Connect cards that can be found in the seat back in front of you, or on our app. You can find them there as well. If you don't have our app yet, I don't know why, you should. It's the best app on the whole App Store. It is, being a little biased, but the best way to get that is to text LFCOG space APP to the number 77977. You'll get a link from a company called Pushpay. You click the link and you can download that on your smartphone or tablet. It doesn't work on your flip phones. We tried it, sorry. But today, again, as I mentioned, is all music service. So before we get to it, we want to be clear. Today is not a talent show. It's not necessarily a concert. We are in this and worshiping together. So maybe you'll come across a couple songs that you're unfamiliar with, and that's fine. And we're not going to have everybody stand the whole time. You certainly can if you'd like. But if you come across a song you're not familiar with, that's okay. Sit, listen, soak it in, close your eyes. But if there's a song and you just want to sing along, that's the point. So please do so. A few of our other announcements, some things that are coming up. The first, and this is a big announcement, and I forgot to say this on Wednesday night when I was doing my devotional thoughts. Wednesday night services in person are coming back on Wednesday. That's a big deal. Yes, Wednesday. This coming Wednesday, things will be back. Beth Steele will be teaching one adult class, and it'll be happening in this room. The youth will be in the gym. And they're still stuck with me, so yes. All right, so right. There will be kids ministry. Will happen in the classroom outside the fellowship hall. And Landmark Littles will also be available. Our Wednesday night services. It's been a while since we've had them, so I need to remind you. They start at 6:30. Wednesday night services start at 6:30. So. Not this Wednesday, but we are working on some of those in the future. We're going to have some dinners again in the future as soon as we can. A few other things coming up. We are in the middle of Mary's Cradle's 12th annual crib campaign. They are buying cribs for families in need. They cost $150 a crib. If you can make a donation for one or two or 10 cribs, you can certainly write a check to us and put write a check to Landmark and put Mary's Cradle in the note section, and we'll make sure they get that. But also, if you're like, man, $150, I got like $10 right now. Well, you can do that too. They will take that $10 and combine it with somebody else's $10, and before you know it, we got one or two more cribs out of your pocket change. So if you can help them in any way, shape, or form, please do so. Landmark movie night is coming up. We're going to be watching the movie Chicken Little, which is an underrated Disney classic from 2006. I like that movie. It's a lot of fun. But it'll be Saturday, June 12th, starting at dusk. So when the sun starts to go down a little bit, we can watch the movie. It'll be right here, right out front. Bring a chair, bring a blanket, bring whatever you want to sit on. We'll have some popcorn and some drinks available. You don't want to miss that. Invite your friends. This is a community event, and it'll be outside. And yeah, Chicken Little is a kid's movie, but you don't have to be a kid to come. If you just want to get out of the house and watch a movie, a free movie, you can come and do that too. June 12th. We also have some camp meetings coming up. Church of God is, that's a big part of our heritage as the Church of God, is these camp meetings. They've been doing them since the 1800s. It's a big deal. And we have two in the state of West Virginia. The first is Craigsville, and it happens at the Craigsville Campground, and that is June 20th through 25th. And there's information about that camp meeting on the bulletin board as you walk out of the sanctuary today. And the second one is the summer celebration at Rippling Waters Campground, and that is July 25th through 30th. Both of these camp meetings have activities available for children and adults and all kinds of other stuff. And I'll tell you some more about Rippling Waters as we get closer to that, but the Craigsville information is, as I said, on the bulletin board on your way out. Also coming up in June is the Rocky Railway Vacation Bible School. That is June 27th through July 2nd. We are teaming up with our sister church on Mahood Avenue to put this on. They'll be hosting it at their location, but we are going to be putting in a lot of legwork as well, working together to bring a vacation Bible school to our community. We are in need of volunteers for pretty much everything. So if you are interested in helping, or if you're just curious what needs to be done, please contact Lauren. Can you raise your hand? Find her, contact her. If you're watching online, you can contact us at the church on Facebook or email or through the app, and we will get you connected with the person you need to be connected to. There is a volunteer meeting June 6th at 5 p.m. for those who are already signed up and interested, and you will get jobs assigned out and all the things that you need to know on June 6th. And the last thing I have to say is our West Virginia State Youth Camp is happening at Rippling Waters Campground July 7th through 10th. Now, on your bulletin, there is a website where it says you can register online. That is not the correct website. It's not going to work for you. The best way to register for that, since registration is all online, it's all digital, the best way to do that is to use the app and go to the announcements section, and you can find the link to camp there, and that one is accurate. Or you can go on to Landmark Youth Group Facebook page, and you can click the link and sign all the papers there. The price goes up on June 6th. It's currently $120. It goes up to $180. So if you know a kid that wants to go, make sure they get signed up ahead of time. Those are all the things that I have to say. Let's pray together as we get ready to worship today. God, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunity we have to come together and to sing some songs, but not just sing songs just for the sake of singing, but God, these songs are all designed and developed to help us understand something about who you are and who you are to us. God, we pray that the words of all of the songs we sing today, whether they're new songs, whether they're old songs, whether we enjoy the style or not, God, we just pray that you'd speak to us today. Speak to us through this music, through these words. Touch our lives. May we not simply be entertained, but may our lives be changed this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. Will you join the worship team standing and let's sing us a couple songs together? I'm going to start off with the song from John 3:16, God So Loved. Thank you. have some special music from our kids.
Not a coconut. Fruit of the spirit's not a coconut. If you wanna be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the spirit's not a banana. The fruit of the spirit's not a banana. You wanna be a banana? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the spirit's not a watermelon. The fruit of the spirit's not a watermelon. You wanna be a watermelon? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the spirit's not a lemon. The fruit of the spirit's not a lemon. You wanna be a lemon? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the spirit's not a cherry. The fruit of the spirit's not a cherry. If you wanna be a cherry, You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Okay! Everybody knows that grapes come in bunches, so everybody get in big bunches. The fruit of the Spirit's not a grape. The fruit of the Spirit's not a grape. You wanna be a grape, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. The fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control.
Kids, is going to be one of our Vacation Bible School songs, so pay attention. You probably already know it, and I think most of us know it pretty well. But why don't you join us standing? We're going to sing Power in the Blood. You may be seated. I'm going to sing a Southern gospel song this morning for Frida. This is one of her favorite songs too, but Christina had asked me to sing it also.
In prison chains, with bleeding stripes, Paul and Silas prayed that night, and in their pain began to sing. Their chains were loosed, they were free. I bless
Sheila. Isn't God good?
Yes.
This next song that we're going to do for you, you can just stay seated for the next two songs. This one is called Holy Water. It's by a band called We the Kingdom. It's fun to check out on your Spotify or whatever you're listening to, your playlist. You could add We the Kingdom in. But there's a line in the bridge that goes, I don't want to abuse your grace. God, I need it every day. It's the only thing that ever really makes me want to change. It makes me think of this verse, Romans 2:4. Don't you see how wonderfully kind, tolerant, and patient God is with you? Does this mean nothing to you? Can't you see that his kindness is intended to turn you from your sin? Now, sometimes we have those voices of condemnation and stuff. We know when we've done wrong, right? But if you're hearing you're worthless or you're no good or you can't ever change, that's not God. God's kindness, God speaks in a kind voice and a gentle voice. It's an encouraging voice. It's drawing you to him. And I pray that you'll hear the voice of God drawing you to him this morning as we sing this song. That we have done this song as a team, and it's definitely different. This song's called Rattle. Anybody know Rattle? Okay, yeah, it's fun. But up here, if you've got your bulletin, you can write this down, and I'm gonna give you a homework assignment. I'm like trying to be like Jeff when I grow up. There's two things that are referenced in here. Ezekiel 37, 1 through 10, it talks about the valley of dry bones and bones coming alive. And also 2 Kings 13, 20 through 21, it talks about the prophet Elisha and how he was buried. And then there's these random people coming along in a funeral procession, And they toss the dead body into the grave with Elisha, and he comes alive. Weird, right? But it's in the Bible, and you can find out for yourself when you read it this week. So that's what it's about. But the song is really kind of about bringing things back from the dead. And I know that over the last year, I've had a lot of things that just didn't work out the way I thought they would. Hopes and dreams and things that I wanted for my kids, for my family. We're all feeling this. And there's all things that we wanted that didn't work out. They feel like they're dead. But God has this wonderful way of taking things that seemed hopeless and bringing them back to life. If that's your situation, if it's a sin that you're dealing with, you feel dead inside, God can bring you back to life. That's just how he is. That's what he specializes in. So here's Rattle.
Impossible, never stop you.
Okay, and now for the first time ever in front of somebody besides the praise team, our own Isabella Cartwright is going to play for us on the piano.
There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart and flesh may fail. There's an anchor for my soul, I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I'm here rise when He calls my name. No more sorrow and no more pain. I will rise on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knees and rise. I will rise. There's a day that's drawing near, when this darkness breaks to light, and the shadows disappear, and my faith shall be my eyes. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won.
To hear from kids.
Yes.
I love that we've got our kids getting involved in stuff, and that's wonderful. This next song features one of our kids, or her first solo ever, Emma Miller. And some other people too, but you know. For the first time, Emma. This one should be familiar to you guys. It's Living Hope. Why don't you join us standing if you're comfortable, and let's sing this beautiful song together.
I'm
come and bless us with another song.
So you guys know I never sing without talking, and it's a nerve thing. So guess what? You get to hear me again. One of my favorite stories when I was a little kid was about David and Goliath. Because, you know, when you're a kid, that sounds so awesome. How does this little boy who, you know, nobody really knows exactly how old he was, but he wasn't very old. And you're thinking, how can this kid with these little tiny rocks and this slingshot, how can he kill great big Goliath, who everybody else is afraid of? And I remember hearing somebody say, it wasn't really the size of Goliath, it wasn't really the size of David, and it certainly wasn't the size of the stones. It was the size of David's faith. And you know what? Sometimes it's hard to have that faith. Like I told you guys the last time I sang, that I've had some real giants lately. And I'm still working on them. Still working on them. Just like God's still working on me. And so when I was thinking about what I was going to sing today, I kept thinking about all these giants. And a couple of years ago, I heard a sermon on David and how it wasn't just that David had great big faith and it wasn't just that Goliath was so big, but, you know, David was a shepherd and shepherds didn't really have things like we have now to protect. So he had just his slingshot, but you know what? They were trained with those slingshots. So David knew between his training and God, he had it all. He had the accuracy to shoot his slingshot and take care of that bear or that mountain lion or whatever it was that came for his sheep. And he knew if God could protect him in those situations, he'd protect him against Goliath. And God honored his faith. And so I've tried to remember as I've hit these giants. My heart is racing like 100 miles a minute, and I tell you guys, every time I sing, doesn't matter how often or how in often, my heart gets right up here, and my mom reminds me that's because I'm doing it for the right reason, because I'm honoring God, and there should be a little bit of something in honoring God that makes you just a little bit, please, Lord, let me do this for your service, not so that I hear feel great or anybody thinks, wow, Christy's awesome, but so that God gets all the glory. And so even though it kind of sucks to have that heart up here in the middle of your throat, I also remember that's really awesome too, because I'm remembering how important it is to honor God. Now, Paul, if you don't hit play, I'm going to start crying and I'll never get through this. So how about we go?
Ah!
So don't you be afraid of giants in your way. With God, you know that anything's possible. So step into the fight. He's right there by your side. Stones inside your hands might be small, but watch the giants fall. Watch the giants fall.
Like Chrissy, I'm going to run off at the mouth for just a minute, too. this song is kind of new, I guess. It's new to me, anyway. It's going to be really difficult for me to sing, so bear with me if I cry, I'm sorry. But as most of you know, my mother is not much longer for this world. She's had a lot of complications. It's been a very rough couple of years for her. And this song says so much to me because through everything, through all of the pain that my mother's went through, I know that when it's her time to pass, God's going to hold on to her because he promised he would. He would take the sting of death, and I know he's going to do that for her, and she will pass peacefully. And I know that he's going to keep his promise to hold on to me and my family as we grieve for her. And as much as I believe that, I believe that whatever anyone sitting in here is going through, God's going to hold on to you too. So you just believe that and bear with me.
When the best of me is barely breathing, and I'm not somebody I believe in, hold on to me. When I miss the light, the night is stolen, and I'm slamming all the doors you've opened. Hold on to me. Hold on to me. Hold on to me when it's too dark to see. Nobody loves me better.
Jesus, hold on to me.
Thank you, Christina. Thank you, Christy. Thank you for just sharing part of your heart and soul with us. I'm going to ask you to stand one more time, worship with us. This song will probably feel like an old friend.
Been through a lot in the last year and a half or so. Everyone in this room has some things that they're either going through now, some dangers, toils, and snares that you can think of. So this morning, some of you may have picked up that those verses were a little bit out of order, but there's a reason for that. God's grace has gotten us through everything we've ever come to, whether this side of heaven or the other. His grace will always lead us home. We're going to sing that verse one more time, and then we'll be dismissed. That'll be our prayer as we leave. Yes? Sure. Absolutely. We'll sing this verse, and then we'll pray for Sydney. So if you guys want to come up front, we'll get you. Sydney this morning. He's okay right now. He's not here, but he's just hanging out with some buddies. But a couple weeks ago, he had a four-wheeler accident. Banged himself up, but he's okay from that. But while they were checking his injuries, they found a benign tumor in his head. So he's going to have surgery soon to remove that. Again, it's as far as we know, it's harmless, but brain surgery is a scary thing, especially on a young man. So we're going to lift him up in prayer today. God, we thank you for Sydney and all the life that he brings to whatever it is he does. The energy that he has. God, we thank you for protecting him so far. That accident he had a few weeks ago could have been significantly worse than it was. God, we thank you for that accident, because we never would have found some of those other things if they weren't doing their concussion scans and all that. So we thank you for that. And God, we pray just as you had orchestrated all of this up to this point to discover those tumors, we pray that they would continue to be benign and harmless. God, we also want to lift up the doctors and the surgeons and all those involved as they seek to remove these things just so they don't cause any issues further down the line. God, we know that you are the great physician. There's nothing too hard for you. You formed bodies, put everything together the way it should go. We pray that your wisdom and your grace and your guidance is upon all those who work with Sydney. We also ask that you would give an extra measure of peace to his family. It's hard for a parent to see their child undergo something like this. So we trust in you, and we trust that you have him. We trust that your hands will hold him and guide the doctors, but we also ask that those same hands would provide comfort and peace to his family and to him. He may not seem like it, but we know he's nervous and a little scared too. God, we pray that you would touch this family, heal him up, put him back on track to doing all the dumb things that he loves to do. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Anybody else have anything they'd like for us to pray for this morning? In that case, let's pray together to be dismissed. God, we have come together this morning to sing songs of praise and songs of worship, and the overarching theme today has been your provision, your guidance, and your grace in us, in our lives. God, we thank you for those things. We thank you for saving us from sin, and for saving us from ourselves. God, we pray that we would take the message that we've heard this morning out into the world. There are so many people who need to hear. There's a God who saves. There's a God who guides. There's a God who heals. There's a God who gives hope and peace and comfort in the midst of these storms that we all face in this life. God, give us the courage, give us the words, and give us opportunities to share this message that's changed our lives with anyone we come in contact with. God, we pray that you would empower us, embolden us, bring us to life for your kingdom. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You are dismissed. Thank you. Have a great week. Amen.